everyone. Myself, Ms. Thera Arora. I'm going to discuss today robotics in nursing, especially during the COVID-19 pandemic. So we have seen many robots and many machines are being used abroad. But with the pandemic, they are emerging in India also. 2-3 hospitals are already using robots in nursing also, and for general hospital work also they are using. So let's discuss about this. Registered nurses and nursing practitioners are accustomed to emerging technology, making an impact on their work environments and day-to-day duties. While these advances in equipment and technology brings many positive changes, some trends such as robotics are feared because of the possibility that they will take jobs away from the nurses. However, the opportunities for nurses and robots to work together and the innate skills and characteristics of human make RNs and NPs irreplaceable. In overview, in this we have observed that healthcare robotic markets is estimated to grow to 2.8 billion in revenue by 2021. The applications in the healthcare seems endless. The healthcare robot market includes surgical robots, rehabilitation robots, and hospital robots also. So more detailed segmentation of robotics application in healthcare includes surgical robot training, exoskeletons, smart processes and bionics, assistive robots, therapy robots, cleaning robots, logistic robots, then telepresence robots, pill robots, robot nurses, and surgical robots. Then technologies enabling healthcare robotics. These technologies are present, such as gesture control, machine vision, speech and voice recognition, then tactile sensors. And we have benefits of robots in healthcare. It saves the cost, reduce the waste, and improve patient care also. Provide sophisticated levels of measurability and traceability also. Then there are some famous nurse robots which were used in abroad, not in India. So in this first was this was the robot Dinso that was used in by the hospitals in Thailand and Japan for patient care. The skills were for the elderly by the video, and sets up video chat with their relatives and alerts caregivers of patient activity by their phones, and provides reminders for medication and exercise alongside the elderly, and provides entertainment with karaoke and games also. Then next was robot Paro. Its application today is in the hospitals and extended care facilities all over the world. Skills were to stimulate interaction between patients and caregivers. It imitates the voice of the baby harp seal to help to relax the patients also. It is being able to adapt behavior to each patient. Then benefits: reduce the patient's stress, improve patient relaxation and motivation, then improve patient socialization with each other and also with the caregivers. Then there are some sensors present in this robot, that is light, audio, temperature, posture, and also tactile, means for the touch also. Then next robot was robot Pepper. The application today is that it works as reception area for 2 Belgian hospitals, greeting the people, guides patient to the proper department. Skills are, it recognizes 20 languages and can identify gender. Also, it identifies joys, sadness, anger, surprise. It interprets non-verbal language such as the tilt of the head and a frown, a smile, and tone of voice also. Then vision also. The vision is that 2 high resolution cameras are there, and 3D camera is also there. Then shape recognition software processes, captures the images. Then movement, it can move 20 engines are there, and 3 multi-directional wheels enable the robot to move at a maximum speed of 3 km per hour. 6 lasers and sensors are also there. 2 ultrasound transmitters are there, and 3 obstacle detectors placed in the legs help the pepper identify the distance of the objects within a range of 3 meters. Then a question comes, can robots replace human nurses? So of course, the nurses are irreplaceable by the robots. Rather than pitting robots against humans, individuals should consider the opportunities to create by robots in the healthcare, and reasons why robots can never completely replace the human nurses. This is why. First is common sense. Common sense cannot be achieved with the robots. Robots rely on programming and lack common sense, reasoning ability. Example, if a person is considering tipping over a cup and they don't need exact specifications such as shape of the cup and physical properties of the content of the cup or the motion the cup will expose to in order to make a decision. So that common sense will not be with that robot. He may break the cup also while moving fast, right? And he would not be knowing that if moving fast, the tea will come out, right? So this common sense will be not present in the robots. Then next is empathy. Robots require programming to understand the emotions and exhibit response. For example, Pepper, the robot, may have been programmed to respond with emotions, but still it is not capable of fully understanding human emotions. Then creativity. Artificial intelligence can mimic a famous artist's style, but it is not capable of creating art that will resonate with humans. Example, algorithms can be created to produce sequences of painting, but it is much more difficult to teach AI how to recognize the difference between emotionally powered art and lackluster creations. So creativity is also lacking in the robots. Then fourth is the ethical decision making. Of course, the nurses are only aware about the laws and all. When faced with novel circumstances, robots may waste time making a decision that could potentially affect the patient's life. And also they can take a wrong decision in such places. For example, an experiment tested on a robot ability to protect other robots called human proxies from entering a danger zone on table game. In 14 out of 33 trials, the robot wasted time making a decision which resulted in both human proxies falling into the hole. So he cannot make a ethical decision. Then next is how nurse robots offer a helping hand. First is with the repetitive tasks. Nurse robots can take over such tasks, retrieving medical supplies and delivering food and medication and transferring or moving the patients. So these are some repetitive tasks which a robot nurse can do. Then training. Robots can help to train the staff and for education. For example, a robot patient could stimulate a behavior of patient's limbs for patient transfer training. Then after that, education. Students can interact with Dustin. Dustin is a robot which is used for education purpose in Duquesne University, stimulating telepresence in nursing. So according to Joe Seidel, the director of the technology in the School of Nursing, students can connect to him through iPad or iPhone app or any other computer also. Once connected, they can use Dustin to hear, speak, communicate with everyone in the room. Dustin's screen display a live video feed of the person at a distance, so it feels like he or she is a part of the team. And Duquesne is the second nursing school in the US to have the nurse robot. How nurses robots create and expand career opportunities? They can have career opportunities in as a robot coordinator, or a robot continues to become more common in the healthcare. The need for individuals to oversee and the duties of robots will create a new job opportunity, that is a robot coordinator. Then next is robot telemedicine. In this, patient living in rural areas or those who are in the urgent need of a specialist can receive a diagnosis and treatment plan through a robot that can be remotely controlled using a desktop, laptop or mobile services. Nurses will play a vital role in assisting robots and remote healthcare practitioners also. Then third is research. since nurses are well aware of the needs and healthcare environment, they can participate in the technological advancement of developing robots. Then the question comes, how can robots be utilized in the this COVID-19 pandemic? So of course, we have discussed about the robots who are doing various tasks, repetitive tasks. They are able to handle the patients. So I'm discussing some of the robots which are used in India also. In AIIMS New Delhi, Milagro IMAP 9 is a floor disinfecting robot that can navigate and sanitize the floors without any human intervention. It destroys COVID spores on the floor surfaces using sodium hypochlorite solution as recommended by ICMR. Milagro said in this statement, okay. And the Milagro humanoid ELF enables doctors to monitor, interact with the contagious COVID-19 patients remotely with no person-to-person contact, thereby significantly reducing the transmission risk, it added. Then Mitra is for screening, and also RoboDoc is for screening. So they are a semi-autonomous robot designed to be front lines of this war against the virus, and it will screen the patient without exposing health professional to the virus. The technologies, face recognition, natural language processing, and also diagnostic tools. Then next robot is C-Astra. It is for disinfection. These all the robots are invented by Inventor Robotics, that is a Indian company. So in C-Astra, UV disinfection technologies can play a role in multiple barrier approach to reduce the transmission of virus causing COVID-19. UV disinfection technologies can play a role in a multiple barrier approach to reduce the transmission of virus causing COVID-19. UV disinfection technologies can play a role in multiple barrier approaches to reduce the transmission of virus causing COVID-19. So the technology for C-Astra is UV disinfection, lidar-based navigation, which helps it to move, and hybrid human in the loop system enables human workers remotely assist the unit if it is stuck, and also monitor the units for safety. It will enable the high degree of germ reduction without putting humans at risk. Then this is a video which we are going to show. This is Mitra robot, which has been used in Fortis Hospital, Delhi. So here you can see the robot in the Fortis Hospital, and the patient is coming for screening, and it will recognize.
Hi, name please.
Sharad Kumar.
Phone number please.
9030-300-300.
Let me check your body temperature. Please take a step back and look into the camera. Your current body temperature is 100.8 degrees Fahrenheit. Do you have a fever, cough, throat pain or difficulty in breathing?
Yes, I'm feeling feverish.
The screening is complete. Now you will need to go to flu clinic for further assistance.
Hi, Sharon. I see that you have fever with high temperature. Let me connect you to the doctor.
How are you today?
I'm feeling feverish, doctor.
Do you have any throat pain or breathlessness?
No, doctor.
It looks to be normal fever and not COVID. Mitri will issue the entry pass for you.
Thank you.
Please collect your pass and proceed through gate number 2.
So I conclude my topic. So no doubt healthcare today is an exciting, rapidly evolving industry. Technology companies have noticed the needs in the healthcare setting and are continuing to develop and advance technologies that will benefit both the patients and the healthcare professionals. Students entering the field will face the challenges and opportunities with the increasing technology, and in adopting and adapting to new technologies and shifting responsibilities as a result. And also these robots are doing well with the COVID-19 pandemic. They are very necessary for reducing the transmission of risk of infection. Thank you so much and have a nice day.